sarcastic.
That was, it was sarcasm, just like my oath to uphold the Constitution and my marriage vows. I guess I'm just too hip for you. Then, let things go a little personal.
A lot of
people die, and a lot more are going to die unless he gets a lot smarter, a lot quicker.
Mr. President?
Did you use the word smart? Don't ever use the word smart with me. Don't ever use that word.
I can imagine Trump's not used to hearing that word around him very much. I'm also trying to paint the difference in Canada's campaign style as a quirk.
President Trump, you're holding large rallies with crowds packed together, thousands of people.
Outside,
yes, sir, I do. Vice President Biden, you are holding much smaller events. Why are you holding the big rallies? Why you not?
We already know the big rallies are bad, Chris. This is like asking, Mr. President, you're tying ladies to the railroad tracks as the choo-choo train approaches. Mr. Biden, why did you go with the strategy of not killing your supporters? Why did you try to explain that crowded Trump rallies were a health risk?
He's not worried about you. He's not worried about the people out there breathing in one room. No negative effect. No negative effect. No negative effect. And we've had 35,000, 40,000 people who wanted these rallies.
No negative effect from your rallies. That's an interesting point. Herman Cain, your thoughts? Herman Cain? We're having connection issues with the great beyond. Though Trump lamented the damaging effects of the lockdown.
You look at what's going on with divorce.
I mean, everywhere you look, there are wives saying to their husbands, Donald, the second you're out of office, I'm leaving you and your unspeakable burger farts. War crime. She used the word war crime. She's going to drag my ass, my literal ass, to the egg. Come on. You got to find your happiness where you can. Trump bragged about how he's rescued the wide world of sports.
And I'm the one that brought back football.
To which the Cleveland Browns fan said, yeah, we're good. Trump then tried to defend paying so little in taxes.
Before I came here, I was a private developer. I was a private business people.
I was a private business people. It was me and a bunch of bees that I made up for tax write-offs. The people. Then Joe just got down.
You're the worst president America has ever had.
Come on now, Mr. Vice President. That's not fair. He's also the worst president America will ever have. Trump tried to hit Joe where it hurt. His record.
I've done more in 47 months, I've done more than you've done in 47 years, Joe.
That's possible. But volume isn't everything. The nuclear bomb did more in Hiroshima in one day than any politician did in history. But something tells me it might have cost Truman the Japanese vote. There was an interesting moment of civility from Biden.
It's hard to get any word in with this clown. Excuse me, this...
Hey,
this
let me
person.
Just...
Good thing Joe corrected himself. He wouldn't want to lose the clown vote. It's also not accurate. If Trump was a clown, he'd have a much more professional face paint. Then Chris Wallace announced he was going to ask a question about race.
We're going to go to the next segment. I'm going to ask a question about race, but if you want to answer about something else, go ahead.
Chris Wallace, restating America's official position on racism. Then we arrived at one of the most telling, one of the most upsetting moments, not only of the night, but of my lifetime, when the President of the United States was asked simply to condemn white supremacy.
Are you willing tonight to condemn white supremacists and militia groups?
I'm willing to do anything. I want to see peace.
Then do it, sir.
Say it. Do it. Say it. You want to call them? What do you want to call them? Give me a name. Give me a
white
name.
White supremacists and white supremacists and white proud boys.
Stand back and stand by.
Didn't do it. I don't support white supremacists. I just command them. Like a dog. That's why I've got this shiny dog whistle. Proud boys. Proud boys. Stand back. Sit. Who's a proud boy? You're a proud boy. On foreign affairs, Biden said Trump wasn't an attack dog. He was a lap dog.
He's Putin's puppy. He still refuses to even say anything to Putin about the bounty on the heads of American soldiers.
Okay, that's not true. I'm not his puppy. I'm his BFF. I'm Kim Jong-un's squash partner. And I'm Recep Tayyip Erdogan's emergency soul cycle contact. Trump explained the massive forest fires in California aren't climate change's fault.
the forest floors are loaded up with trees, dead trees that are years old, and they're like Tinder.
They're like Tinder. You swipe right, you swipe left. Either way, total smoke show. And they are DTF, down to forest fire. After one particularly long Trump spittle-filled blather, Chris Wallace tried to get things back on track.
Mr. Vice President answered his final question.
The final question is, I can't remember which of all was ranting.
I'm having a little trouble myself.
It's funny, because we are facing the most important election of our lifetimes, and we're letting the idiot who shouts the loudest decide what we talk about. Now, Trump ended up ginning up fears about the next election.
This is going to be a fraud like you've never seen.
Oh, I don't know. I'm looking for a pretty big one right now. And when Chris Wallace asked Trump if he would call on his voters and stay calm, instead, Trump made a frightening call to his followers.
I'm urging my supporters to go into the polls and watch very carefully.
Maybe go hang out there wearing your favorite brown shirt and just, you know, assess the situation. And after an hour and a half, soul-pulverizing menace, I feel like I did coming out of Star Wars Episode One, The Phantom Menace. How can we possibly do this two more times? And ultimately, I think the American people, they were hurt tonight. And if you look online, they're angry. Because this is a serious moment where human lives and the future of this irreplaceable country is on the line. And I know that Chris Wallace says he's not a fact checker. But after 1.5 hours of chaos and lies, I can say there's one statement tonight that was absolutely true.
This is not going to end well. This is not going to end well.
We got a great show for you tonight. Later on, we'll have a performance by Public Enemy, but when we return, I'll get a debate reaction from Senator Cory Booker. Stick around.
Today we're discussing some Necron rules previews from Warhammer Community, new stats and special rules for the Void Dragon, the Necron Monolith, and the Silent King. Hello and welcome back to War Specs Tactics, the strategy focused 40k channel, where today we're doing a bit of a roundup for all the rules that we know about these guys so far. I must say that some of these rules are looking incredibly scary for the Necrons, particularly that Void Dragon. In the video, we'll look at what they've previewed and talk about how strong these rules are likely to be. Let's jump straight into it, starting with that new Catan. So first of all, we have the beautiful and disturbing Void Dragon miniature, who does seem to have got a bit of a statline buff compared with the previous Catan. Compared with the Night Rider, he gains an additional wound, an additional attack, and he's also got a 3+ save, unlike the Nightbringer, who at least in the previous edition, was only protected by a 4+ Imbol save. The 9 wounds does mean that he shouldn't be targetable, as the Catan up to now have always been characters, which means that your opponent shouldn't be shooting him turn 1 at least, which combined with his Necrodermis rule, which we'll see in a second, could make this guy just ridiculously problematic for your opponent. On the damage dealing front, he's got the Spear of the Void Dragon, which he can either throw at range or attack in melee with his 5 attacks. At range is a 12-inch heavy 1 weapon with strength 9, AP minus 4 and damage 6. I suspect most of the time with that short range it'll just be essentially a single shot, but it has a special rule where you draw a line between this unit and its target unit. Every unit that it passes over you also get a hit against. It does mean that you might be able to spear multiple vehicles or something if you happen to have them all lined up in a row. So essentially a boosted las cannon shot against some things, but if you do make an attack against a vehicle with it, the damage characteristic changes to D3+3, rather than just D6. Quite a big boost, but it seems to make him very good at hunting vehicles, as that's an average of 5 points for a successful wound, compared with an average of 3.5 for a